Welcome to Easy Learning, designed by me, that is Sujit Kumar. I am going to teach you JEE Foundation Batch, and my topic will be Mathematics. In this lecture series, the first topic is Quadratic Equation, and I am going to help you in solving some problems. But before describing about the maths, the question, I would like to share my profile with you. My name is Sujit Kumar. I have done BTech in Electrical Engineering. I have 2 years of work experience in Tata Consultancy Services, which is a multinational company, and my designation was Assistant System Engineer. Now, I am going to teach you quadratic equation. I know you know very well about the topic, so I am going to describe about the some questions which are frequently asked. I have taken the question from the last JEE advanced questions, IIT JEE question. See, the question is what? The coefficient of x to the power 99 in the polynomial x minus 1, x minus 2 up to x minus 100. We need to find the coefficient of the x to the power 99. And we have some options. So if you want to try, then you can also try. If you want to solve the question from on yourself. Okay. See, what is the way to solve the question? As we need to find the coefficient of x to the power 99, see, we have total of 100 terms. Okay, these are the polynomial x minus 1, x minus 2, and so on up to x minus 100. If we want the coefficient of anything, suppose x to the power 5, x to the power 10, then what we need? We need that many power to be multiplied and rest the constant. So if we really multiply x from every particular term, okay, this is the first, this is the second, so on, and we leave one term, then we will get x to the power 99. In this way, we can find that by leaving one, we are getting x to the power 99. So minus 1, second time minus 2, minus 3, then so on up to at the last, we will get minus 100. So if we add as a whole total, we will definitely get the coefficient of this, and hence we will get the answer. There's another way also, finding the coefficient. It means up to 100, we need we can use permutation and combination in this. Okay, we will find 100 c1 plus this way, leave this, but in a simple manner, and I have made the solution for. See, we have the polynomial x minus 1 up to x minus 100. What it will give? It will give x to the power 100 minus 1 plus 2 plus and so on up to x to the power 99. As I have told you, by keeping one term separate, okay, and rest should be multiplied, then we can get the required answer. So x to the power 99 can be received with this, and here what are we getting? One summation up to summation of the series from 1 to 100. Okay, natural sum, and we know the summation of the natural sigma n, and it is what? N into n plus 1 by 2, and so this is the formula. So n is 100, 100 into n plus 1 means 100 plus 1, 101 by 2. So we will get the answer minus 5050. This is the our answer. Okay, I think you have got a brief information of this. Now I would like to move further in the next question. Okay, question number 2. If 2 plus I, means I is here iota, root 3 is a root of the equation is x square plus px plus q is equal to 0. where P and Q are real, then P, Q will be what? Okay, we have some options. Option A, P equal to 4, Q equal to minus 7. B, P equal to minus 4, Q equal to minus 7, and so on. Okay, you can get. And the last is the none of the above. If you know a little bit of the quadratic, you are I think you will be able to solve this question. Okay, because this question is quite simple. See, in quadratic, how many roots can we get if it is a pure quadratic? Definitely 2. Why? Because we have the maximum power of 2. So we will definitely get 2 roots. Okay. As it hasn't said that P and Q are what, but okay, it has said P and Q are real, and it has said that it's one of the root is not real, but it's imaginary, means we are handling complex numbers also. So if one of the root is 2 plus I root 3, then by convention, as the mathematician know, the other root should be what? It's 2 minus I root 3. Okay. It's pair, conjugate pair, which is said if one root is any complex number and the coefficients of the equation is real, then the other root should be the conjugate pair of the complex number. So the other root should be 2 minus I root 3. And as we know, the summation of root always gives what? Coefficient of the power x, and the product of the root gives what? Coefficient of the power x to the power 0, which is constant. Okay, so from this we can find the answer. I know you if you have still some problem, I have met. Just look at this. See, as P and Q are real and one root is 2 plus iota root 3, others would be 2 minus iota root 3. So hence we can get P, which is minus sum of the roots, means the coefficient of x is minus 4, and Q, which is the constant, which will be product of the roots according to the quadratic. I think you may know. If you want, I will give you the complete lecture on the theory part also. But this is the introductory part. So for this, I am making this question, so it helps you. Okay. I think I have covered the lecture, and hopefully you have understood. If you have still doubt, you can ping me or you can do the comment on my inbox. Okay. If you still want to know further, my profile through which you can comment or you can connect with me. This is my Facebook, this is LinkedIn, this is Twitter. Thank you, friend.